Good morning, everyone, and welcome to another Bitcoin and blockchain tutorial available at chaintuts.com. I'm just leaving my polling place this morning. It's the 2018 midterm elections here in the United States. And so in honor of voicing our opinion about democracy today, I'm going to do a little opinion piece on why I think that Bitcoin as digital gold is kind of bad for cryptocurrency adoption in the long term. So it's kind of a controversial topic in the world of Bitcoin is, what should Bitcoin be? Should it be something that's a day-to-day transactional currency, or should it be something that's viewed as a speculative asset, as a long-term investment, as the price of Bitcoin continues to go up and up and up? So there's two schools of thought on this. The first is, the price of Bitcoin has risen so much over time that Bitcoin is a great way to make and store money. So a lot of people have decided to put money into Bitcoin actually as a sort of investment, as a long-term way to gain some value, to diversify their investment portfolios. And the other school of thought is what I think is sort of the more original school of thought around Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies, is that it should be a day-to-day transactional currency. You should use Bitcoin to buy a t-shirt, buy a coffee. I actually bought a t-shirt with Bitcoin the other day on the Bitcoin.com store. So it's certainly still useful for that. Here's why I think Bitcoin should be viewed as a transactional currency, and I'm talking specifically about Bitcoin and not sort of every cryptocurrency that's out there in the world. I believe that Bitcoin, the original Bitcoin or Bitcoin Cash, first and foremost should be viewed as a transactional currency because it's the face of cryptocurrency out in the world. A lot of people say, you know, Bitcoin has become a store of value, it's become digital gold. But regardless of how it's viewed in the crypto community, Bitcoin is still the face of digital currency to the world. It's the first and it's the most widely seen and, you know, most widely talked about in sort of the mainstream media. And so the problem I have with viewing that as a digital gold rather than a transactional currency is that most store owners, most merchants, most everyday people that decide, hey, I want to get into Bitcoin, are going to go specifically to Bitcoin first. They're not going to go to Litecoin. They're not going to go to Dogecoin or Ethereum. And so if these merchants and these individuals start to pick up Bitcoin, and all of a sudden they see that, you know, it's $5 in transactions fees, it's $10 in transaction fees just to send money to someone, they're going to get frustrated. And I don't think that people that aren't necessarily technically oriented around the cryptocurrency world are going to say, oh, well, I have an alternative in Litecoin, I have an alternative in some other currency that's better suited towards these day-to-day transactions. I think they're just going to give up on cryptocurrency adoption entirely. People also talk about the Lightning Network, you know, payment channels as a sort of longer-term solution to scaling, you know, the Bitcoin core chain. And I think that's problematic too, because right now, frankly, the Lightning Network software is buggy and confusing. I don't even know how to use it yet. I haven't got a chance to get involved with it. And from what I understand, you know, it's a piece of software that requires, you know, a significant amount of setup work on top of just understanding how to use Bitcoin at the, you know, standard Bitcoin blockchain level. So that's why I think it's better if Bitcoin presents its face to the world as a day-to-day means of transaction, and that, you know, we continue to scale Bitcoin in a way that keeps on-chain transactions as low fee and easy to use for people that are just getting into this fascinating technology. So, of course, this is just my opinion. And like any opinion, you know, I hope that it's informed and that it's, you know, that I came to this based on research. And I would encourage everyone that's watching this video to do the same. Please don't take my word for it and take my opinion for it. Go out and do some research on different ways of viewing Bitcoin and digital currencies and how they should be used, and come to your opinion yourself. So, as with all of our tutorials and opinions, I hope you found this video interesting and informative. Of course, there's a text article available on the Chain Tutorials website if you just want to do some more reading on this. And as always, thank you very much for watching.